Hey guys, my name is Jakob, and today I'm representing my PhD thesis called Modeling Text Data Over Time. We'll present examples on job postings dataset. This work is supervised by Professor Dr. Tunja Mladenić. A quick overview. We'll begin with problem statement, then we'll continue with proposed approach, first results, and finish with future outlook. Okay. So, the problem statement. The problem we have is that we have a lot of data, a lot of job postings data. This data is multilingual. It is unstructured and is timestamps. So we can break our problem segment into three different problems. We have to unify representation, which will handle multilinguality. Then we have to cluster and model the data, and then we can predict. We can play with prediction and we can play with knowledge extraction. So in order to do modeling, we have to handle multilinguality and we have to handle it for a large amount of data. So we proposed a method that will handle a semantic representation of domain-specific short to mid-length text that is computationally effective. This is the first part. Then we will model it, we will cluster it, and then for future work we will do prediction. Okay, so let's start with overview of proposed approach. This is the first and the second part. So unifying and model. So our text data is a single job postings. It can come from German, it can come from English, whatever. We input it to Wikify. This is called Wikification. It is semantic enrichment that will unify whatever language you input, if it is represented in Wikipedia, to set of concepts. So basically, it is a function that will map text data to a set of concepts. Then we'll input those concepts to LDA. Once LDA converge, we will extract those learned parameters. We will do some manipulation with it and we'll for target variable. Then, after all that is done, we will replicate this procedure with deep learning LSTM model in order to obtain embedding. This embedding matrix will have arbitrarily small dimension, and because the embedding dimension we can specify and the number of concepts is not so big. Everything in here is computationally not so demanding, for example, as learning Holberg model. Okay, so now we go through each of the parts in a little more detail with examples. So Wikification. So this is example of Wikification. So you have a job postings that you input and you get out a set of concepts. So what it does, it basically creates a language neutral semantic representation and enrichment if this language is represented in Wikipedia. The beauty of the Wikifier is that it can handle the synonyms, it can handle abbreviations, and you get all of that in super dense form. So for example, we have here a phrase ML engineers, leading a team of talent ML engineers, which obviously mean machine learning engineers, because this is how our brain works, we know it. And Wikifier actually maps this ML to concept machine learning with the strongest weight. So this is already, Wikifier already enriches our data and return it in the form of a set of concepts. So after we have a set of concepts, for each document, we can represent a whole corpus and model it with LDA. After LDA converges, we extract so-called per topic, per concept, per word probabilities in so-called beta matrix. Now, beta matrix, for LDA to converge, you have to specify number of topics. We selected 50 in our example. And this beta matrix, each topic has those probabilities that sum to one per topic. So topic 32, for example, will have betas that will sum to one. But each concept is represented as a row in this matrix. This row does not necessarily sum to one. So for example, we have a concept programming, and this is the it's distribution over topics. But the betas of a programming does not necessarily sum to one. So what we did is we said, okay, now normalize it. Now we require sum to one and create another view. So how does it look? For example, here the distribution over topic programming has the three strongest clusters named 32, 45, and 39 that it belongs. So you can now we can see a distribution of each of these topic in natural LDA. Even without any manipulation, this looks pretty amazing. So for example, you have topic 39, which is clearly a programming topic. You have Python, you have C++, you have C programming. The size of the word indicates how strong is this beta probability. You have C#, you have embedded system, you have Java, and so on. And then you have Linux, Unix, and so on. This already looks like a really like a representation that one could use. So what we did with normalization, we create another view. So you can imagine a very rare concept, for example, decision tree that does not appear often in job postings, would be a really small here, would have like minuscule beta, but its beta on all other clusters would be zero. So when you normalize it per cluster, this beta would become like really huge in this certain topic. And then if it appears in job posting in the when you look it back, if decision tree appears, you would know, okay, this has a strong pointer to this topic 39, even though we might miss it, which is natural. So this is the two views that we create, and then we replicate both of them with deep learning. So this is this part, if you remember here. So this is the probability manipulation and target variable. And I unfortunately don't have enough time to go into how target variable is created. I will just present the embedding results. So after LSTM model converge and we extract embedding, we can observe the cosine similarity of concepts to see how good our fit was. So for example, I chose deep learning, and the concept that were very close in this vector field are NLP, natural language processing, computer vision, TensorFlow, natural language, and so on. So these are the concepts that you would deem semantically close if you look at concept deep learning in the field of job postings. So this is why we call it domain-specific embedding, because it captures importance based on what you model. Same story goes with programming language. So okay, we select programming language and we want to see what is close to this concept. So we get C++, we got Python, we got library, we got object-oriented programming, R, MATLAB, and so on. So what we can see here that we created a very good semantic representation of our space. So how does this benefit us? Each concept has its own vector. Job posting is a set of concepts, so we can vectorize with job posting. Now we can choose certain time step, certain time of day, and vectorize all job postings in that day, and then just add them together and do average. And we can create some kind of representation of this day, how was distributed in our field. So for example, here we created our IT job posting space field that was for some kind of hierarchy that was deemed important. And each concept has its representation in its hierarchy. So for example, this is the representation of deep learning. We can see that it has strongest pointer to this artificial intelligence part and the data processing part. Not so strong to user interface, and then testing quality falls, and then digital security, data management, source code management, it goes up again. So this is how we can represent. So the results, you can map concepts like C++, we can see that increased drastically in Germany over time, or you can code it in all countries, or you can model whole clusters. Like we can just this name data science and ML, which is basically artificial intelligence cluster, and we observe how job postings behaved over time compared to this cluster. So we can see that, for example, United States of America during the Corona times, this cluster gained a lot of importance. So this is relative demand. So this means either job absolute number increased and also AI increased, or absolute number decrease and AI stays the same, something like this. So, but we can measure the same. So these are our results. Now for future outlooks, we want to improve modeling in the demand side of job posting sector. We want to develop and design a suitable model for prediction. And we want to know, we want to investigate the effect of separation of the data on time or geographical location. So for example, if the data only in Germany would create a better model that if we know everything. Then we want to observe possible correlation from real world problems where knowing demand in future might be, is deemed useful. But overall main contribution to science we can separate main contribution to science to cost effective method for creating domain specific embedding, evaluation on real data from job demand, and possible model that we have to create. Okay. This work was supported by Slovenian research agency and European Union project Homenea, and mentor is Dunja Mladenič. Thank you for your attention.